Well, I forgot to roll for these suckers. So 3 through 6 makes the barrages available, and if we check here, these are all possible. So first is Vichy. They're gonna have an available gun. First British is not. Second is, so I've got the cruisers available. This is important because had there been a reserve over here that could be used for the naval operation. Now, this first barrage segment is aircraft and ships only. There's a few things I want to take care of. I want to try to strike this. And we got, what, a 10 hex range from the airbase. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so we're safe from any kind of fighter cover over there. And for that factor, there may be other air bases kicking around, though, that I can't see. So, let's see. 18.28 had an air base. That's over near Damascus. That's not going to affect us. And 5.11 has an air base. Which is only going to affect up there. So now the question is, what do I want to use, say, my naval gunfire for? Well, I'm going to drop that on here. Now, I had to do this during the movement phase to place it there. But now I can try my barrages. But I got to look up where these fuckers come in, as I gotta see when they happen. At the end of the movement phase, after the barrages, so I get to do my barrages first. So let's try one. And here comes the hard part, because now I gotta remember, hey, are naval barrages all spotted? I think that's the case. I'm not sure where to look that up. This is always a difficult thing. And yes, I'm in a better mood. I'm not being a total bitch anymore. Yeah, they're spotted. So that'll help somewhat. I'm going to want to knock out this unit because, well, disorganize it. I think, you know, maybe I should be hitting something else. Maybe I should be hitting this stack, which could be really obnoxious. I don't know. Okay. So, my total barrage strength is 9. Which puts me over here. My shifts, well, I get a shift against me because there's only one regimental equivalent in the hex. Any others? The terrain is clear, so that's not a problem. I think, unlikely to hurt anything, but I really want the DG for the landing. I can cope with these later or whatever. So I go from the 9 down to the 5 to 7. I need an 8 or more. Any die roll modifiers? Doesn't look like it. I do not get it, and my ship is done. Okay. Now airplanes. I don't have a whole hell of a lot here. I have a tactical bomber and a fighter. And I have to make my choice. I'm not sure how you mark. Oh, there's active and inactive box. Okay. I was going to say, I don't know how to put it under the counter. So the question is whether I want to hit here, where the reserve can definitely intervene on me. But I'm, you know, without spotter. Or over here, where I'm really not sure if they can. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I think I'm too far away. I could look up what's in that hex. That's 4532. Ow, that hurt. If I can find 4532, wherever the hell that is. There it is. Okay, so I can look at the front of the units, but I can't see what the back looks like. Now, I know there's a 10 speed unit in there, but I don't know what those infantry turn into. I think movement's reduced on reaction. So this is where I want to drop my attack. And we'll go here. I think all the French planes have to be up there. No, there's one at 1828 near Damascus, but I believe the range is 10. And that might be scaled. It doesn't look like there's any scaling effect on that. So, yeah, so I have another bombardment, but this one's not so good. First of all, I start at 6. Density shift. It looks like there's 2 steps in there. So I'm not going to get hurt from that. It is that tannish or greenish. I think that's the hills green. There's very close terrain. So that shifts me a column to the left. What was I on? 6. I'm down to 3 to 4. There's no correct spotter. That gets me down to 1 or less. And that's it. So I need an 11 or 12 to disorganize those guys and strip the reserve. And I get nothing. And I hope I don't have to pay supply for these. I think they resupply for free. Refit for free. All right. Well, I guess that's all I have. That makes us look for the sequence of play again. And now we're in the supply phase. At this point, I have to find trace supply everywhere. Remember, it's like 5 movement points back to a place. So these guys are all in trace. These guys are in trace. Over here might be more difficult. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, shit. Did I screw up? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No. So this is, I think, a point of interest. It's a something. Oh, I can't tell. There's a brown thing there. Yeah, there's a hyphen. Oh, no. That's the road mile marker. That means nothing. So I screwed up and I'm out of supply. One hex away is close enough, right? And down here I'm going to be in trace. I'm near the railway. All kinds of stuff there. Okay. Yep. Okay. So if we're all in supply, we don't mark them with our out of supply markers. And now we're in the reaction segment. French get to make their reaction moves. I forgot to put anything in reserve. I don't know that there's anything that I can put in reserve because I moved all my units. So the Brits have wasted their reserve capability here. Yeah. All right. One thing I did want to do though is I want to move my fighters, actually. And I have 2 choices of air bases. I want to get them on map so that they can protect things. I have 2 choices of air bases. I have over here out in kind of clear terrain, and then here protecting my units going up the coast. I'm going to protect the coastal units. And because I'm in range, I don't slip under. I'm not inactive. I don't know how useful this is, because if we look, the French have a more powerful air force at the beginning, I think. They have a couple of fighters and only one attack bomber, but whatever. Now, for the French, the reaction movement, they get half movement. That's pretty easy with some of these. These guys, for example, they're in move mode, one, two, and they're done. We'll put that over here or something. You know what? I'll put them over in the holding boxes. All right. So that's fine and dandy, but... Oh, I forgot to move my fucking trucks. Yeah, I need to move some of these. So this loaded up. That's one movement point, 10%. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We'll keep these loaded just in case we want to move them further, but they're good there. And I have more trucks somewhere else. Well, I have to break some points out of there to make that work. But I think I want to slide some supplies up this way. A couple more of those. Oh shit, I actually could have done certain things. So some units have been actually dropped into reserve. There were some units I didn't move that they're motorized stuff. I'm probably not going to reserve move them, but who the hell knows? Okay. Oh, fuck me. All right, before the reaction, I have to check for this shit. Okay, let's find those goddamn Commonwealth commandos and see what happened. Okay, first of all, will they happen at the end of the movement phase? On a 4-6, they're delayed until the exploitation segment. Yay, they're going to be delayed. Good, I can forget about them for a little longer. Because I really don't see what the fuck they're going to do. They're these little units. But they do cut off the supply line. And that's the big thing, because the French don't have much up here. All right. Did I do my French bombardment? No. I did my reaction movement, some of it. Scattering out of here. Now, I had some screw-ups with this artillery. I had it in motorized mode. I swapped that out. I didn't realize what I was doing, but, you know. We're going to see a lot of that shit here, because this isn't really something you're going to learn from. You're just going to see my frustration of trying to learn the system. But I have this last reserve here. Now, I want to move this infantry forward, but I can only move him 1.5 movement points. Well, that's plenty. There's one movement point, and he's where he needs to be. But what about the artillery? Do I want to move artillery up? If I'm going to be doing an 8-point barrage, I mean, first of all, I don't need to move the artillery. I'm within range that I can fire. But if I start to win, that would be useful. So that's an 8-point barrage. There's a stack of a few units. I could figure out how many by looking at the setup, but I can make a guess. I have a chance of just making that attack not happen, basically. The disadvantage, though, is if I disorganize it at this point, it's not going to... it's not going to stay disorganized. I'll have to fire again if I'm launching some sort of counterattack, which I probably am not going to be doing, but... Do I want to try to halt this? I think I do. Normally, you wouldn't want to use artillery defensively like this, but I'm under a reserve marker now. I'm in all kinds of different color terrain, including rough, which is very close. Oh, wait, there's different levels of map. Oh, shit. how do you tell what's what? But anyway, this is very close terrain, which means I'd get a shift against, I'd be down there. I have my spotters. I have to pay 2 tokens of supply. Uh-oh. Oh, this is where I'm not sure it's a good idea. 2 tokens of supply, and I'm here. I guess I need an 8 or higher to disorganize that force. Oh, but there might be a bonus. I think there's like 5 steps there. I'm not sure. So that's right 2. So I was an 8. I went down 1. Now I go here. Looks like I need a 6 or better. I miss. Okay. I'm going to get rid of this reserve marker because it really doesn't serve another purpose since I've moved already, I think. Again, you have to know everything to be able to do anything. I got planes, though. Now, I've already hit this hex, so I have to remember that I can't hit it again, right? This is not a game that you can easily walk away in the midst of a step, unlike some other games that I like to play with. Okay, so what about my aeroplanes? Well, here in Riak, I have a mixed fighter. Okay, well, now here's what I can do, and this is kind of crappy. I can do a fighter sweep, and I'll do that. I'm going to go after these mixed fighters. They have to fight, and now we're going to be on the air combat stuff. I'll be back to deal with that. Honestly, I need to mark what I've done because right now I'm here. I need a break. I can't cope. I'm here in the barrage segment doing a fighter sweep. And hopefully I'll remember that. Let's put this here to help remind me. For the fighter sweep, oh geez, you know what I forgot? The British plane, when it struck, should have undergone flak. We're going to ignore that because I don't even remember. I think I was hitting up there. All right, let's go back to that in a moment. But here we've got air combat. The French are 1 better than the British. So that gives a +1 to the 2 dice, and the other die is an off. 6, the attacker aborts, and he takes a step loss. So he goes back here, and I can put him over in the inactive side here, keeping the other unit on the board. So this was a success for the Brits there, but now I have to look up the flak rules. And I don't remember if these suckers, yeah, they do have a good index. I know, some of the other gamer stuff doesn't come with very rich indexes. The CWB, for example, does not. I don't remember if LLB did. Okay, flak is somewhere around 14. We checked this. We're not in the patrol zone, but we did do a bombing strike, so we are subject to flak no matter what, because we were hitting, you know, some useful thing. So roll 2 dice. If we roll an 11 or more, we kill an aircraft stop. This is modified by the flak points affecting the mission per the charts and tables. Oh, joy. Okay, so maybe they're over here. I didn't see them in the other side. I do not see flak here. Here we go. Okay. Size of the mission. Well, the size of the mission doesn't matter. Okay. So, no headquarters, no airbase level, intrinsic flak of the map. There isn't any. Target hexes and enemy PZ, no. So, I think there's no modifier, so I need an 11 to hit him with flak. And I did not get him. Okay. Alright. Now, on to other French air missions, huh? Well, I think my next air mission is, if I can find it, I should have a plane here. This is another fighter, right? I can't read. It has a fighter capability. So this is a fighter with very limited bombing capability. I'm going to send this here too. Unfortunately, this time we're at even. And there's no flak for the fighter sweeps. Okay, this time we roll a 10. That's a defender aborts, but with no effect. Now, the defender has to abort in his own hex. He can't flee back to where he can recover cheaply. The attacker has succeeded in his mission. He can return wherever he likes. He'll go up here where he can recycle without paying anything. I have one last opportunity, which is my bomb. I can't strike here because we already hit that. The question becomes, do I want to slow the Brit or try to slow the Brits down here or here, really? Well, alternatively, I could go over here, but this is so unimportant comparatively. I think I've got more forces that can hold the coast. This is in a kind of key location, protecting some other things. So I'm going to send my plane down here. The undergoes flak. Now there's an anti-air unit there, huh? Is that what that is? Shit. And that doesn't affect flak? Yeah, there's an anti-air unit in that hex. And you're telling me doesn't look like it, which I find very strange, but okay. So the flak happens actually before the bombardment check. Well, if anti-air is supposed to have an effect, it would have shifted it to an effective flak. Now I've got a 6 bombardment hitting this grayish terrain with a little Spluk that I think is one of these. Grayish terrain. Hey, that's low hills. That's close. Close, I believe, is a shift. Yep. I do have a correct spotter. And there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Why you don't stack units together? That's right 2. So my 6 goes right 2 to here. Now I'd have to pay 3 for this. I can't remember now. 1, 2. That's the 12 to 16 column. I need a 6. I get a 9. That's a half in brackets. What does the bracket mean? If in a level 3 hedgehog or more. Oh, it just turns into a DG. Okay, 4 through 6, a step is lost. Okay, so we got a step loss and a disorganized marker, and I think that's going to pretty much prevent the attack from being worth making. And finally, we get to the commandos, who are my bugaboo in this game, because just part of that first setup thing. Okay, so we end up moving north on a 1 or 2, hitting the hex on a 3 or 4. 5 or 6, we got problems. We're going into the enemy location here. So for the first unit, he's going to be landing in the hex. Same with second. Third is going to go down and get screwed. Okay. So we roll 2 dice looking at the amphibious landing table. Now here, we need to put a book marker in place because this is over here. So we're hitting open terrain. Failures on a 2 or less. Okay, so landing hex adjacent to a non-DG attack capable unit, that's -2. Landing attempt in 1941. What the hell? This game only has 1 year. I don't know what year it is. That's the problem. Okay, well that's helpful. Great. Do we have the date anywhere? Somewhere? I don't know why. 1941. So that makes it 3. No, -4. Alright, these aren't going to be very likely. And it's just for the hex, I believe. We'll do top unit if it's not. 6 -4. It sounds like we actually succeeded to land. Well, that'll add some complexity to our game. Oh, wait, we're supposed to roll 2 dice and look at the amphibious landing table. Wow. That makes it a lot easier, no? I don't know. I can't remember what the table says. Alright, well, with 2 dice, yeah, we're going in. So, did we only have to roll once? That's what I think it is. So here it says, you roll for the success or failure of each hex containing... But then it says, place the commando in the landing hex. I think we landed. I'm not sure. However, the other one is occupied by an enemy unit, and each such landing is a beach assault in the following combat phase. That's probably not going to go terribly well. Each Commonwealth movement phase, including turn 1 after the landing effects. Well, that's no longer a Commonwealth moving phase, because these happened in the reaction phase, so I think we're not going to get supply this turn because we landed too late. Damned if I know, because that screws us completely. So I'm going to say we have to, because we won't have, we're in supply right now, but next turn we won't be in supply. Well, it doesn't say when. I don't know. I think the intention is we'll be able to get supply there. But I've got to do a landing using the beach landing rolls. And, well, that's something else that needs to be looked up.
Right. Make as few rolls as possible.
There's a nominal hexide terrain that makes all units times 1/2 when attacking. But the defender could choose the internal hex, which is, I guess, a minor city instead. The minor city other than being very close, which I can pick that anyway, isn't going to be a problem. Like, I'd get the times 1/2 on armor, but I'm not facing that. Okay, so I think we just fight, whatever that means. For some reason, I guess there's a surprise roll. This is not an overrun. So we look for the surprise table. It's down here. It's a 10 or more. Do we have any modifiers? Both units are 4s. There's a little yellow circle around my 4. Oh, fuck me. I don't know what that means. All right. Time to look through, and I suspect this is going to be in the specific rules for the game, for the reluctant enemies, what the hell that means. I'm going to guess, but I didn't really look too hard, that it means they can't use their value if they're attacking with other units, because I know that's a rule, and we'll pretend that means it. So we're at even on the surprise roll. We get an 11. The attacker has supplies at 2-column shifts. Now, the defender had to spend a token. Uh-oh. Great. Well, I gotta make change here. Doesn't have to spend supplies because of the landing special rules. The defender did, however. Okay. So now we're at something. Minor city is very close terrain. See if we can find the combat chart, which puts us on the second row down. Our odds are 2-6, 1-3. That doesn't sound pleasant, but this game can be a little, that's all the way at the end. And this game can be a little weird about that. So, but we have 2-column shifts due to surprise. So we're over on this table here. And now we're at +2 to the die roll. No, I thought because of surprise, but no, we're the same quality. I don't know why I'm rolling so many dice. I roll a 10. Are there any modifiers? No. Okay. So attacker loses 1. Defender has an option. Well, the defender does not want to lose his only unit, so he'll retreat a space. And he's not disorganized because he only retreated 1. Now, where are we? I think we're in combat. I shouldn't have done that yet. Because the British, as the attackers, have an opportunity to dump barrages. I doubt they're going to do it. But if they have any artillery in place, they might choose to blow supply on a barrage. I'll probably do that in conjunction with my attacks. I know, always follow the sequence of play. This game is very, very strict about that. But honestly, especially if you're dealing with one of the bigger monsters, not so much with this one, but there's only going to be a couple of attacks. Where there's only going to be a couple of attacks at a time, it's not that big a deal. But if you're dealing with one of the bigger monsters, man, you want to kind of segment the board and not worry about all the possible bombardment opportunities that you have throughout the course of, you know, six maps or whatever. Looking over the map, I did look at everything first. I want to try to get into the pattern where I kind of following the sequence completely. So yeah, I'm going to do the barrage first. Here and here, I don't feel like I need one. I've got fairly good odds. Here I already won a battle. I don't need it there. Here, I counted my points, and I don't think I can fight a battle. I'm halved if I'm disorganized. I have a lower quality. I think I got stymied there by the planes. That leaves one. I've got artillery in place. It's an expensive thing to do. But I don't think I can make this attack easily unless I can barrage that. So I'd be firing a six barrage. That'll cost me two tokens. That's a lot. There's no question. And I'd better be in range of a headquarters. There's one. But I think I'm going to do it. See how our supplies all work out here. So that's a 6-point barrage. And let's put that here. Now, I've got some serious disadvantages. So this is brown, tannish, greenish terrain. This is going to be this stuff, which is actually very close, the rough. So that's what? A column against me. I have a spotter. I'm not in strap mode. Okay. Now, density. There's only two steps, which means no penalty, but no help. So I'm here looking for a 9, which isn't good at all. But if I can beat this hex, and I think the barrage is necessary for that, it kind of opens up this main road to a large extent. And that looks pretty appealing to me and worth a shot. I do not get in there. Okay. Now I can choose to do my combats in any order I like. Might as well think about this one. So I know what the French have there, essentially. I have 18. I don't know if I want to throw that in. 22 strength points. What's the quality? Again, I kind of know this. These guys are the reduced quality units, but I don't know which way they're reduced. Which is to say, I don't think they go up to fives. So I think they're threes right now. All right, let's look at the combat chart and think about it. We're in very close at 2-1. The average does not look good to me. I don't want to spend the supply for this attack, so I'm going to hold off there. Let's go down to this one. I'm not going to make that attack. This one, I know what I'm facing more or less. Wow, that's a crappy unit. So I've got 8. Wow, I got a lot of artillery there. So I've got up to 6, 15, 19 strength points. But here's the thing. You don't want to expend a lot of supply in attacking. So what if instead... Hey, but the problem is if I bring a light unit, I get an advantage. I don't have any real crap here. All right. Why don't we bring 15 strength points? Which gives us pretty good odds. That's 3 units. I'm going to have to spend 3 tokens for the attack. And I'm going into that rough terrain, which is very close. Armor and mechs are halved. I don't think we have any of that. So it's 15 to 2. That's going to be 7.5 to 1, which will be 7 to 1 on the very close. That only gets me to 6 to 1. All right, well, we get surprise. I'm going to lead with one of my cav. Maybe not that cav. What did I say? I had 15. That means, yeah, I got to lead with my good cav. Oh, well. I have a 4 quality. They have a 3, so I have plus 1. This is not an overrun. I'm not going to get surprise. I do get plus 1 on that, 6 to 1 very close table. I get a 10. That's pretty good. Attacker gets an option of 1. Defender loses 1 and gets an option of 1. Okay, well, the defender's destroyed. I can retreat. And we left someone behind here, along with this artillery. I can retreat. I don't take the supply, but that supply is kind of hanging out there, so I don't feel too badly about that. The last attack is over here. How much do I want to throw in? Well, again, I'm facing 2. This is going to be in greenish terrain, which is close instead of very close. I'm going to send 14 strength points in, I guess. I don't really get to look at the odds, although I do know what's here. 14 strength points. Am I in range? I'm in range of this. So that's 3 tokens again. So there we go to that. And I'm using a 3 quality unit one way or another. I'm going to use these crappy guys. We have first. Oh, you know what? I forgot to spend. This was 1 token. I gotta spend a token here for this guy. I gotta roll for surprise. Ooh, that's not good. Okay. 3. The defender has surprise in that case, and it's a 3-column shift. So we were in close terrain at 6 to 1, 7 to 1 really, with 3 columns against us, and now we're down to essentially the 2 to 1 column. No mods, because our quality is the same, and we roll shitty again. The attacker loses 2. I have no options in this. I gotta lose one of these, and I gotta lose one of these. And these are all one-step units. Ouch. Well, that didn't work very well for the attack. I think that's the end of combat. No exploit results or anything like that. Which means we go to the exploitation phase, and at this point, my reserves could move if I wanted them to. Might want to stiffen things with some armor here. There is some open terrain there, so if I defended in that, the armor would be improved, but I'd have to pay fuel to move that thing, as far as I know. So, I don't really want to do that. And there are no exploit capable units that can barrage or combat. That puts me in cleanup, and I think I lose my disordered marker here. I think that's it. Okay, I removed my fueled markers. So I don't get this for the French side of the turn. We kind of knew that. Okay, and when was I allowed? Okay, I'm allowed to refit my aircraft the beginning of my turn. So at this point, we move to the French side of the player turn, and we'll just drop down to there. French side, and we'll just call them the French, not the Vichy French, because the Free French are basically something else. Aircraft refit, we're able to move these all there for free. Normally you can't do this, but that is a special on-map box, and we'll drop those guys over there just because now that they're active, I think it's easier to see that. There are no reinforcements yet, I think. Oh, crapola. If there are, there probably were Commonwealth ones, and what I'm thinking of here is the possibility of supplies. I'm gonna have to look here because here we go, supply. Now that's roads and trace supply, not new supply units coming in. You know what? It doesn't say that I don't get supply or replacement on the first turn. So I think I've got a couple of die rolls to make for the Commonwealth and some things to shift. In fact, it says specifically that I get replacements on turn one. So let's do our supplies. Six, I'm going to get 2.5 supplies, which is two and two. And then replacements. I get nothing. The Vichy don't get replacements. But they will get supplies, not drift. Somewhere they've got them. There they are. But I've got to figure out how to bring these on. Now, I have some rail capacity, which, again, is not just butting up there. Here we go. So I've got a rail capacity of one, which means that I could ship one of these by rail. And I think where I most want it was up here. Can't get it that far. Where do my choo-choos end? I'll send it as far as here. The other one and a half, well, actually, I'll send that one somewhere else. Because the 1.5 can come in at Haifa. I don't know what to do with the one that I have on rail, though. I could detrain it here. This doesn't look like a terribly bad place. Alternatively, how am I doing here? I'm pretty low there. I'm kind of worried about my capacity there, but... I can get to the headquarters, and we can bring later points in from that side. It's kind of nice to bring the points in later after I see what I've used, but these points could have been used earlier. So now I guess we go to the French supply. And I apologize to anyone who really doesn't consider the Vichy actual French. 6, but that's just too bad. All right, so they get 1.5, and they have a rail capacity that allows them to move that. So unless I'm doing rail movement, which I might, because I've got these big interior lines to cover. So I'm gonna let these kind of kick around and think about them a little bit. Because I really do have to make a decision. My other decisions are kind of linked with this. And I feel, for me at least, whether it's cheating or not, that I can make those decisions better in real time. You know, as I say, okay, I need this amount of force for here. So, you know, so when I'm making that decision for movement, otherwise, I have to plan the whole turn kind of in advance. At least my general strategic moves, which I feel like are fairly heavily dependent upon me pawing through my pieces and figuring out, well, can I actually attack this turn? So in the interests of time, and obviously not video time because I babble on and on and on, but in terms of playing and thinking time, and thinking time is the thing that I most value, because here's the deal. If I bring these on now and I do all kind of thinking about it, well, I'm going to be fatigued after all that thinking, and I'm going to wander away, and then I'll forget what it was all about. That's why I hate pre-planning in games, unless I'm writing it down. If I'm writing down a plan, like I do in the Brigade series or something, well, you know, it kind of sticks with me a little better. And I've always considered, gee, I ought to be writing down orders in this, not because they're required by the rules, but so I remember what my plans are. A little bit more foot dragging and everything, but my basic problem with the French is this road being cut. I got some other ones. For example, me having moved this wagon up here, that means it's not going to be available to haul these supplies out. I'm going to have to destroy those supplies or try to. I'm not going to be able to hold this position way up here. Likewise, you know, I have to figure out where I can hold here. These supplies are lost. But I can try to blow them as well. I don't need to have a unit to blow supplies. There's an inherent garrison in place. That may be the case here too, you know. Where I may be able to deprive the Commonwealth of supplies. Now, they made a conscious decision of, hey, let's not advance. But I was forgetting about the fact that the enemy can blow the supplies. Those supplies might be worth more than the points of the troops. Now, I'm a little curious about, there's these special replacement points in this scenario. Somewhere, and I don't know when those happen. Combat unit recovery. In the reinforcements phase prior to rebuilds, track the number of step losses. Okay, So I'm gonna have to start keeping a count here at some point, but the French have only lost 2 units, so they do not have a problem here. And I think I'm right here that all units have one stop. In this, because I got no little skulls, so that would make sense. I seem to remember reading it, but now I'm, you know, doubting it, because I just haven't been able to focus heavily enough on this game. And then there's issues like, hey, I got this naval barrage to work too. That's probably best used against this unit. And that's probably what I want to use it for. I can use these supply for any combat I've got. I'm going to have to fall back in front of this as well. Even though, well, I don't know. You know, I'm doing a great job of holding that piece of land, but it's so hard to make up my mind what I'm doing here. Okay, so my ship fired to no effect over here, and now I gotta decide what dumps I want to blow. Clearly this one I'm not gonna be able to do anything with. I just looked it up, but now I'm like, geez, can I do it if I'm in a zone? A dump can be blown by its nominal garrison. It doesn't look like there's any restriction on the zone of control. So what I do is I roll over here, I roll a die, and as long as I get a 2 or higher, I get, well, no, there's a whole, yeah, there's only a 1 token there. So as long as I get a 2 or higher, I get rid of it. All right, so there goes a couple of points. Something of value to get rid of. And that kind of makes these trails a lot less worthwhile. The Brits are going to be able to push forward up there. Do I really need to come around the side? Well, there is a good reason why I can't hold this position. Because if I want to hold here, I'm going to have to hold elsewhere. But can I launch an attack here? Good question. Where did I put my British reserve markers? Okay. And did I do it legitimately? Yeah. Okay. So I can actually launch attacks from the north where they're not gonna be, where I have more supplies available. I'm also allowed to release one of my restricted units, I believe, at this point. Concentrating a little over here, and I've decided to try to hold this supply dump, at least for a little bit, because the Brits weren't able to push through it on the first turn. Well, now I've got some reinforcement cav in place. I've got a fair amount of forces coming down. I might actually be able to turn the tide there if things go well enough. Shipping materials up here to get behind the Jebel Druz. But then as I'm wandering up here, so I got this thing, which I haven't decided what I'm going to do with. It's a motorized unit with foot movement, but if I want to spend a little bit of supply on fuel, I can drive it, you know, pretty much anywhere. It's got 14 movement points. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. I could get it right up into that fight there, which might be worthwhile. And I'm beginning to question, do I really want to be hauling my supply away from where I'm heading? If that's the case, maybe I'm going in the wrong direction with that supply. Let's see. We dropped these off. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Why don't we move this up this way and get it a little closer? That leaves me a little bit of flexibility there. I've been shuttling it back and forth. Anyway, looking at that, I start moving over here saying, okay, well, what do I want to do? Well, then I see this and say, what the hell is that? And I'm not terribly familiar with the system, so I had to look things up. Well, LT, it doesn't indicate anything. When I looked in the guide here, I couldn't find it. This is very hard to read, so I don't know, but I'm like, well, what the hell? All right, but it has a red movement allowance, which means it's tracked, and it's got red color behind the type designation, which means it's a mechanized unit. And that pretty much tells me the things I need to know. So I'll be using the mechanized column here, which has advantages and disadvantages. What are those little brackets? That's only the attacker, and it's actually affected by... Oh, by the way, these units, I bet you this yellow dot, I remember something about a dot other than the changing values for them. I bet you the dot there is that it cannot be rebuilt. I know those units can't be rebuilt, and I know that there's a dot somewhere on units that can't be rebuilt, and that's the only dots I've seen in the game. So anyway, yeah, I'm trying to, you know, puzzle out what the hell I need to do here, because the British tech just doesn't look that potent, and I feel like it's kind of petered out here, and maybe I can get a counterattack. If I'm correct, let's look up my victory conditions again. I think that's my sudden death. Entry hexes are supply sources. So yeah, Amon would serve as a sudden death if I can, you know, get down that far. And at the very least, if I can start threatening in that direction, that changes the axis of where the Commonwealth is going to have to throw its forces into play. They can't allow that to fall. So, I've actually made quite a bit of progress here for my own, you know, given who I am and everything. Set up, I'm running an attack across here. I think I am going to try to hold this location. So I've shifted some supplies forward, I guess. I don't know how they moved. Anyway, I'm blocking up the path here that the Commonwealth could come down. I see a couple of weak points, right? I've got a lot of strength here where I'm thinking, gosh, I might be able to break through and get an automatic victory. I doubt it. I think a lot of those reinforcements are going to be coming in this way. They either automatically are coming in that way, or and I know the Free French are, or their option, they have an option as to where they come in. It looks like they, well, these guys come in at Amon. 5026 is the next. I don't know where that is. Yeah, we shouldn't get... No, that's right here? In the middle of... Jesus. So they just kind of appear on the Transjordan border. Wow, that... So that's not something I was expecting. They just kind of show up here, apparently. And, well, I mean, you know, if I couldn't see them, I'm not aware of them, right? I have no idea. That does really put into question whatever the Vichy French are doing down there, but I'm not going to try to reverse that. This has happened to me in other games, but usually it's stuff coming on off an edge of the map that I'm not expecting in a tactical game or something. Not stuff just appearing out of nowhere in the middle of the desert, but whatever. Okay. What I'm guessing, and I remember noting this before, is that these are troops that were moving up, and instead of creating rules for them to move up, they're just going to appear on the map there. But honestly, if you're me, that's really not very helpful. I like to see the things moving on the map. That helps me prepare and helps me plan. I don't go looking at the reinforcement charts a lot. But it's not like Doubleday where it's like, oh yeah, they wandered in from there. No, these guys are just invisible troops, French ninjas. Okay. So I'm left with a couple of weak points, though. Here, and I ran the hell out of a truck to get a full point of supply within range of that. And that's great. I'm not facing a lot of Commonwealth troops there, so I don't feel too terribly bad. And then any kind of breakthrough, there's good terrain that I'm going to be defending. But then the other is right here. And I would like to build my hedgehog somewhere around there. I could build it right here. It cost me 2 supply points. I looked that up, and there appears to be no restriction against digging in right on the line, and that's fine. However, that location is kind of subvertible, at least by my view of it, because there's some clear terrain here, and I might be able to get around it, and that would kind of ruin the whole hedgehog point. The problem, of course, is I've got this infantry trying to trickle its way in, and I'd like to make sure that I hold this location, but I'm not positive that I can. In which case, do I leave this here, or do I drop him back so that next turn he can be the hedgehog? Because I can't put it here. The zones of control aren't strong enough. I could be bypassed if I build a hedgehog there. I've got to build it right on the road, because that's the only way to lock supply down. And I'm not sure that this is necessarily a better location than a couple hexes back or whatever. I'm just looking at, this is easier terrain to cut through. And I think I'd like my defensive lock to be there, because I don't have a lot of troops there right now. I might end up devoting some of the coastal stuff back around there, but I've got to wipe out these commandos, because, they're not wearing underwear. That's kind of where I am, but I'm still in the middle of movement. And I'll tell you one thing, I'm having a lot more fun not describing everything on the video. I don't mind coming in and chattering like I am here, but I really hate when I'm trying to show everything that I'm fucking doing, when I'm trying to learn a game especially. Consideration is headquarters. So I can get away with kind of a weak headquarter along the coast. I feel like that's reasonable. 8 hex range for throwing. Gets me down to here. And I've got little dumps along the way that they can draw from. I've got a big road I can take supply from. I don't feel like I have any problems there. Over here, well, this is only a 5 hex range right now. And I don't know where I'm drawing from, to tell you the truth. I think maybe I was able to get all the way here. 1, 2, 3. No. So I'm kind of drawing from just that, which means we're not going to see any significant offensive operations for a while. And I think we're not going to see them at all, because the French are kind of going to get screwed there, because I didn't see that reinforcements would appear in the middle of the map. Large quantity of them. And then the other headquarters that I have to deal with, because I seem to only have 3 right now, is right here. And this can cover here. It can cover Damascus if it gets there. But I have no headquarters for down here, which is why these supplies had to run all the way up. And that's kind of, I feel like the Brits aren't going to be able to take advantage of that situation. They're not going to be able to slip anything behind there easily. it's really hard to do raids in this from what I can see, because let's say I had a motorized unit that had like 14 movement, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, I could make it there, but now I'm out of trace supply, and you know, I've got a check right now, and then my enemy can come slam me down. So the limited number of roads, etc., seems to prevent people from running around doing raiding. Now, obviously, if I had some weak piece of shit that I'm willing to sacrifice to cut off a big army, yeah, that's worthwhile. That's, you know, like the Desert Raiders or whatever, right? I don't care if I lose them and I might screw up their supplies and cause some attrition rolls. Great. But I certainly don't want to risk stuff that's not significantly weaker than what it's facing. I mean, these guys, they're not quite as good, but, and they're also not motorized, so they're not doing it. Plus, I'd have to spend fuel to go do that and all kind of other crap. On the bright side, I wouldn't have to use trace supply because I'd probably capture some stuff there and I could eat some of that, but then I'm kind of stuck there until I find my way home somewhere. Which will work fine if I've got something to bust that up as a follow-through, I guess. Anyway, I'm just kind of musing here. I've got 1.5 rail capacity, and this is what's weird. I have not used any of it yet. I might want to use one of it to rail this artillery up there, although with the Vichy coming in, I feel less that's a less desirable possibility. I used a truck to pull a half a supply down this way, but now I'm left with, well, now I have 1.5 points and I have only one supply left up there. So, like, yeah, I can rail that supply anywhere I fucking please, pretty much, but yeah, so what? You know, I'm wasting a half point of my rail capacity because I couldn't figure out what I wanted to do with it. You know, I mean, I could have moved 1.5 supply someplace. Crapola. So I finished my movement phase, put some things in reserve, and then I realized I needed to do an overrun here. Because if I don't do an overrun, and it's just not being used to this sequence of play, in my supply phase, I have to eat. And I have a lot of supplies back here that are kind of my problem. Now, I could trace, I don't know what this green shit costs. For leg units, it's okay. But, which is this. Why is my truck white print for its movement allowance? I don't know. Anyway, because when you flip these over to their mobilized side, the truck movement should be black print. I don't know if that's a... Oh, that's not a truck. That's a wagon. That's why. Okay. So I can slip supplies a little more easily than I thought. But, yeah. If I don't do something about clearing this trace route, I've got a problem. And did I want to do this? Fuck. I mean, the problem is that I have to go back and undo stuff. Because no way this would have moved where it did, and this, that, and the other. Two REs, which is units in this, as far as I can tell, would cost me one token. And I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'd be eating 3 tokens. I'm just gonna live with that rather than Oh shit, I can't eat that. I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. Well, I think there was like three back here. I could end up with two here, I think, which gives me enough to keep me in combat supply for later. Again, you know, unlike, say, Burma, I'm in a position where I've got problems with supply right from the beginning because of these commandos coming in, because of the terrain here. It's not like Burma doesn't have a lot of trouble, but I feel like I'm being thrown in the deep end a lot quicker with this game than I am with that one, and probably than I am with any of the big ones, except for the fact that there aren't a lot of pieces here, so that, you know, that's a little bit more manageable. I can undo mistakes or whatever. Anyway, that's supply, I guess. Everything else is able to trace. So, I hope. So, now we go to reaction. And this is kind of tough. I mean, do the Brits really need to throw an anti-aircraft in here for fuel? Probably not. They'd have to pay fuel to move it. They couldn't justify it before. They probably can't now. They have a reserve back here. It doesn't look like I'm being attacked. So, again, I probably don't want to throw fuel in to move up there. So, I can skip down to the combat phase, and now it's barrage. And here, the French have the option to unleash their planes. Now, I can't... I think the boats actually fire at this point. I can't fire the planes because I'm using the boats there. I can fire the planes to bust up a reserve unit, I guess. I could have done this in movement as well. I don't really see any point to it. Huh. Nah, the ship barrage happened here. I think I'm allowed to drop a plane on this, actually, at this point. Because there's a combat barrage segment just before the combat segment. Which involves looking up the limitation on barrages and how many I can make. Once in a phase, and this would not be a phase. Is it worth doing? Yeah, you know, it would save me some, possibly some supply, and I've already wasted so much. So I think I can drop one, this would be my only bomber. Am I likely to barrage on defense? Yeah, I am. And in fact, I may just want to, but... Crap. I meant to look to see whether I could build an airbase sometime soon. Because I might want one a little further forward somewhere. Because the range of this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 only goes out to there. And if I could get an air base closer in, that would be useful. But I didn't. See, what I'm thinking is I probably want this barrage defensively. And if I want it defensively, yeah, sure, I could barrage that. But I'm not going to attack that right now. And maybe I want to see how those reinforcements play out and how screwed I am. So, I think I'll hold off on the barrage, which means we go to the combat. And here I am looking at this. I've got 6, 12. I'm not really worried about exploit. Let's make it 18 strength points. I know what's there, but I want to throw that extra little unit in for other reasons. Now here, I have to figure out how to spend these. And unfortunately, I want to spend from here because it's the furthest back. And now I've got to make some stupid change for that as I expend my supplies there. And yeah, I'm ignoring the sequence of combat, right? Which I should be following directly, because otherwise I'll screw something up, and I seem to be doing it properly. Here, I was taking, I think, 3 units to attack, which means there go 3 tokens. These guys have to use 2. They have nothing on them, and they're only in trace supply right now. So they're each marked low ammo, I think. It may be that they don't have to expend ammo at all, but we're not going to worry to look that up unless... These damn things with all the counters pictured on them seem more dangerous than the board, which has counters on it. Okay. So our terrain is close again. Low hills. Nobody's got any multiplier. We don't have armor in here. These are 4 points of infantry. That's going to be 4-1 table on the close table. But first, we need to mark that with a die that I'm not going to use. First, we have to check supplies, and I'm going to make, unfortunately, one of these big motorized units my main unit. I'll use this, I guess. So that gives me a 4 quality, and these things also have a 4 quality, so we're even. This is not... Oh, the attacker gets an extra column. Not much. Okay. And no pluses. And they get a crappy roll. To go along with it, the attacker loses 1, the defender gets an option of 1. One reason that I'm positioned this way is... So that when I take this loss, nasty. The commandos have to take a loss as well. Oh, I had a 5-point unit here. I would have actually done that. So let's put it to a 3. Attacker loses 1 and has an option of 1. Defender has an option of 1. So I'm going to lose the good guy here. But now the attacker has an option of 1. Now, if I don't take my option as a loss, the defender can ignore his option. So I'm taking this thing as a loss as well. And so far, all these units count. I haven't started, using any kind of paperwork or whatever to keep track of excess losses. All of them are excess losses because the Commonwealth hasn't gotten a refit chance for those, and the French were at 2 losses, so they didn't get counted against them. So that means we don't get an exploitation, basically, but we could move some of our reserve units. We don't terribly want to. They're in reserve as a defensive reserve. And I think we hit clean up, which... I guess the Brits can remove their reserves, huh? Those come off. I don't need them. I'm trying to think if there's anything else. Nobody's disordered or anything. Which means, I think we have made it into a new turn. And that's pretty impressive because we'll actually have an initiative determination roll there. All right, took a while. It should start getting easier. I should start using the camera less
and actually just playing the game more. I'll still fuck up all over the place, I know it. But, you know. All right, let's put it up.